The sufficient condition. Sufficient condition means first we need to consider C1 A2 minus C2 A1 whole square equal to A1 B2 minus A2 B1 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Using this, we have to prove that these two quadratic equations have a common root. In these two cases will exist. Case 1. A1 B2 minus A2 B1 equal to 0. In the case 2, we'll take not equal to 0. Suppose if you take A1 B2 minus A2 B1 equal to 0, if you substitute in this, what will get it? This total value is 0. Get it C1 A2 minus C2 A1 equal to 0. Right? Now, see the simplification of this one. A1 B2 equal to A2 B1. Now, that implies A1 by B1 equal to A2 by B2. Similarly, here also, C1 A2 equal to C2 A1. From this, what will get it? C1 by C2 equal to A1 by A2. Now, we have to prove that these two quadratic equations have a common root. Now, consider A1 B1 C1. Take A1 common, get it 1 comma B1 by A1 C1 by A1. So A1 into 1 comma. What is a B1 by A1? It is A1 by B1 is A2 by B2. If it is a B1 by A1, what it becomes? B2 by A2. B2 by A2. Similarly, what is the value of C1 by A1? That is, here this one, C1 by A1 equal to C2 by A2, that value writing here, C2 by A2. Now, A2 take common. What will get it? A2 comma, B2 comma, C2. So, A1, B1, C1 equal to A1 by A2 into A2. Comma B2 comma C2, which means we can say that A1 B1 C1 is proportional to A2 B2 C2, right? Which means the coefficients of the quadratic equation, first equation, is proportional to coefficients of the second quadratic equation, which means from this we can say that A1 x square plus B1 x plus C1 equal to 0 and A2 x square plus B2 x plus C2 equal to 0 have common root. This is the first case. What is the first case we consider? It is equal to 0. Now, second case. Case 2. Considering A1 B2 minus A2 B1 not equal to 0. A1 B2 minus A2 B1 is not equal to 0, right? Now, I'm considering that let alpha value, I'm taking that. Alpha value is C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by B1 A2 minus B2 A1. Considering alpha value is C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus, just take it as A1 B2 only. A1 B2 minus A2 B1. We can take alpha value. Now, this alpha value, we have to prove that it is a root of the quadratic equation. How will prove? Just substitute this alpha value in the first equation. What is the first quadratic equation? A1 x square. So, A1 alpha square plus B1 alpha plus C1 equal to 0. Substitute in this alpha value, A1 into alpha. While substituting C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by B2 A1 minus B1 A2 whole square alpha value written plus B1 into alpha value again C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by B2 A1 minus B1 A2 plus C1. We have to prove that equal to 0. Right? Now that implies A1, it is a total whole square, right? So we can write a numerator square, denominator square. What is a numerator? C1A2 minus C2A1 whole square. But we have the value of C1A2 minus C2A1 whole square is this one, right? Which means in place of this one, we can write this total. Now I'm writing that value. Just observe here, it is total whole square, numerator square, denominator square, write out, and in place of this numerator square, we can write this total, plus, remaining is same as it is. Right? Now observe here, B2A1 minus B1A2, this one term we can cancel it. And next step, take LCM. These two terms are same. So the LCM is A1B2 minus A2B1. So in numerator, what we have? A1 into this term. So multiplied becomes A1B1C2 minus A1B2C1. Here, B1C1A2 minus B1C2. A1. Next up, plus C1 into, we'll get it. Plus C1 B2 A1 minus B1 A2 C1. Now observe the whole term in numerator. A1 B1 C2. Where is that A1 B1 C2? This term, right? So clearly these two terms will be cancelled. Like that, every term will be cancelled. We'll get it 0. Which means that we can say that alpha is a root of the first quadratic equation. Similarly, we can prove that second quadratic equation also satisfies alpha value. So this is the necessary and sufficient condition if the two quadratic equations have the same common root. So that is that this is the condition. Remember, this is the condition.